Hi there. In this part of the course, we are going to see why it's useful to do data visualizations. In fact, here is the list of the main benefits to do data visualization. The first thing is actually this is the possibility for you to compare data between different databases. Let's imagine that tomorrow you are tracking your visitors on your website with Countly, for example, and you have an additional tracker on your website, which is the one of Matomo. And the idea is that you, for some reason, you suspect that the data either in Matomo or either in Countly are not right, and you would like to compare one with another. So without a data visualization software, what you will do is that you will always have to switch from one tab to the other one in order to compare the two set of data, whereas with the data visualization software, you can combine those two data sets within the same software in order to just compare it with one another. So that's the first main benefit. The second one is that it's going to add, so as well calculated metrics, the possibility for you to have alerts and notification systems. So if you look at information systems such as Countly and Matomo, both of them have a notification and alert system, but just to let you know that using data visualization software is as well about using it for any kind of database that you have, such as Mastodon, such as Twitter, such as any kind of database which may not provide you any alert system at all. So in fact, thanks to data visualization software, you can use the alert system of the data visualization software in order to be notified when something's gonna happen. As well with data visualization software, you can perform what I call a calculation. So just a simple example. Let's imagine that you are taking this given report of Matomo, for example, which is showing the page URL, the page view, the unique page view, the bounce rate, and average time on page, and so on and so forth. And let's imagine that you would like to calculate your own rate. For example, like dividing the number of page views per the number of unique page views, or whatever other thing that you would like to do. Let's, for example, imagine that this given column that you can see over here with the percent rate, you would like to stick it and you would like it to appear within one column between those two. That's typically the kind of thing that you can do with data visualization software. So you can make your own calculation, create additional column who does not exist by default, and make them available within your data visualization software. As well with data visualization software, which is kind of the art of the software, they allow you to make data visualization. So to say, if you take one given report of the information system that you are used to have. So for example, let's take Mastodon, right? On Mastodon, I have this list of people who are following me. Let's imagine that I would like to create a curve showing the number of people which are added to my instance from time to time. I cannot do it with Mastodon, but with data visualization software, I can extract the data out of Mastodon and create my own chart on my own curve or whatever. With data visualization software, you can as well add some comments. So it's true that on some software, you have the possibility to add some comments. So that's the possibility that you can add. For example, at a given date, you can add a notification. That's the case over here. But if I take, for example, here in Matomo, if I just sign myself in, if I just pick up, for example, this one, and if I select an overview report, you will see that I have the possibility to add at a specific time an annotation like this, and say, okay. For example, here I added the fact that I added some fake visit within my website. That's the annotation that you can see here. But most of the time, when you add some annotation somewhere in your information system, doesn't mean that it will appear within the final report that you will publish. And that's typically the kind of thing that you can do with data visualization software, which is about giving more sense to your data by adding extra captions and comments. And as well, the huge advantage of data visualization software, in addition to the fact that they are attractive thanks to data visualization and comment, is that you have the possibility that you can easily share those given dashboards. Most of the time it's dashboard with others. And that's the reason why we are adding an extra layer of software, which are called data visualization software, for all the main benefits that you can see over here. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.